Every time you ask a question in the bot and you want to save that answer, you have to store it in a variable. Think of a variable as if it was like a box that you can name and store things inside. In this case, those things are values you give to that variable. In Landbot, all variables start with an at symbol. For example, if I have a question block that asks the user for his favorite color, and you want to save the answer to later use, for example, in the flow, you have to create a variable associated to that question block. So we'll divide the video in four sections. First, the different formats the variable can be. Secondly, where and how you can create your variables. Then, a simple use case on how variables can be used. And lastly, the importance of giving each variable a unique name. So to start this off, the different formats are string. This is the most flexible type of variable. It is usually used to save a string of characters inside it. These characters can be words, sentences, numbers, dates, signs, emojis, hyperlinks, etc. The next one is number. Here you can only store numbers. Use this type if you need to perform math operations later on. Date, to save dates inside this variable, in the most common date formats. And array. An array is a data structure that contains a group of elements. Typically, these elements are all of the same data type, like a string or number. An array variable is very handy if you're a developer or if you want to try out more of our technical features and workarounds. Let's now pass on to where and how you can create variables in your builder. Usually, we'll create variables to the question blocks we have in the flow, since for us, it's important to store what the user is saying. Each question should be associated with a unique variable. As you can see here, the question name block will store the name in the variable @name, the email block in the @email variable, and this buttons block asking for the average user's budget in the @budget variable. It should be like this for all the question blocks whose information you intend to save. Let me show you a quick example. Let's create a question name block associated with the variable @name. Continue that block by adding a question email block with the variable @email. As you can see, both blocks automatically create the variable for us. Other blocks like the buttons block or the question number block don't do that. So remember to create a variable if you intend to save that answer. If you don't like the name of the variable displayed, you can easily change it by typing and creating a new one. So after these three blocks, create a message block saying, "Hi, @name, is @email your email? And are you really @age years old? Normally, we would continue building the bot, but just for now, we'll leave it like this and keep it simple. Press save, go to share and preview it. Okay, here I'll type my name, Nick. Now for my email, I'll write nick@test.com. And for the age, I'll say 55. And as you can see, the bot has used the variables to write the message with my name, email, and age I just selected. This technique is commonly used as you get closer to the user and achieve a more human-like conversation. Cool, now let's see why it's important to give unique names to your variables. For example, if we create a buttons block with a variable options, and we follow the block with a different buttons block, but the same variable associated with it, the variables would overwrite and Landbot would only save the last one. That's why you should give unique names to your variables, such as option 1 and option 2. To show you this, let's start by creating a first buttons block, asking what burger they want with buttons like chicken and beef. Now, create the variable @options. Lead the default path to a new buttons block in which we will ask for a drink. Here, our options will be Pepsi and Coca-Cola. Now, choose the variable @options too. And lastly, add a message block with the message, "Is @options correct?" Press save and let's see how the bot behaves. So here, let's select chicken and here, Coca-Cola. And as we can see, the bot is giving us the last value of the variable @options. In this case, Coca-Cola, meaning that the bot wasn't able to save the first option we chose. That's because, as we mentioned before, both question blocks save the information under the same variable, and the variable overwrites itself with the new information. And that's why you need to create variables with unique names in order to save the answers you want to later use. So, to round everything up, let's recap. First, we saw the different format the variables can be. Secondly, where you can create and modify your variables. Then, a simple use case on how variables can be used. And lastly, the importance of giving each variable a unique name. So that's it. Hope this was useful and I'll see you in the next one.